This video is a demonstration of the features of Simple CRM, a straightforward, low-cost contact management system aimed at small businesses. Simple CRM was created in Microsoft Access in such a way that you can use it as it is, or customize it yourself, or ask us to customize it for you. You can even use it as a start point for a larger system incorporating more than CRM. So if you want a way of keeping track of all the details of your contacts, of recording who you have spoken to when, and when you need to get back in touch with people, Simple CRM might be the perfect tool for you. We have pooled all of our many years of experience creating contact management systems for businesses into a simple solution that allows you to store your contacts and their contact details, log all contact with them along with setting follow-ups, view a to-do list to manage your contact activity proactively. It also provides the facility for linking folders so that you can store documents, images, and any other files associated with each contact and access them from their database record. So let's take a look at Simple CRM and see what this looks like in practice. This is the front screen of Simple CRM. From here, you can access all of the other features within the system, such as the address book containing contacts, and the to-do list to help you keep up with your contact activity. You can also access library lists of static data on the admin tab. There is only one library list preset in the standard Simple CRM. As you can see, you can customize this front screen so that it shows your logo. Note the message at the bottom of the screen saying press F10 to close any screen. Simple CRM is set up with this quick key that ensures your data is always saved as you go along and any settings you may have changed in a screen are cleared. Note that you do not need to worry about saving any data manually, and any edits that you make to a record will be saved when you move to another record or close a screen. Now let's look at the address book. Using the address book. The address book is for adding, viewing, and editing details of a contact and the history of any activity you've had with them. Let's start by adding a new contact. We will click the Add New button in the top right of the screen to move us to a new blank record and put us in the Search Name box. The search name should be a unique name to use when searching for this entry. For a person, this might be their surname followed by the start of their first name, or it could be their first name followed by the start of their surname. For a company, it's likely to be the abbreviated form of the company's name, so whatever you would call them. In this example, we will be adding a contact named Jeffrey Smith, so we will enter Smith Jeff here. We can now enter the contact name and salutation. The contact name is the full name of the contact, how it would appear on an envelope. The salutation is how you want their name to appear after dear at the start of a letter or formal email. We can now enter the rest of the details for the contact, including if they are a customer or supplier, or both, or leave them unticked if they are neither, and any general notes about the contact. You can add a history of any interactions with your contact, for example phone calls, appointments, meetings, etc., in the contact history area of the address book. In this example, we will add details of a meeting we had with Jeffrey Smith. So we will first click the Add to History button to start entering a new history record. The date will automatically be today's date, but we can edit this since this meeting took place on a different day. We then select the type of contact this is and enter some details about the meeting. You can add a follow-up date for when you want to follow up on an interaction. This will add this interaction to the to-do list so that we remember to do it. In this case, we want to check back in with Jeffrey next week about the meeting we had, so we'll enter a date for the following week. Ignore the date completed for now, since we will fill this in from the to-do list after we've followed up about the meeting. You can also create and view a folder for storing any associated documents related to Jeffrey by clicking the View Folder button. Let's suppose in this case we have a project brief from Jeffrey that we discussed at the meeting. He sent us the document via email, and now we want to save it into his folder. we click the View Folder button and click Yes when asked to create a folder. This will then open up the folder for us to view. We now open up the email and drag and drop the attachment into the open folder. If we now imagine we have finished with Jeffrey's record and close it, we can take a look at how to pull up his record again later and take a look at the project brief document. Go back into the address book and use the Find by Search name at the top by simply entering in the search name we are looking for. You can then click the View Folder button and we can see the folder we set up earlier. The document we were looking for is inside the folder. Using the to-do list. From the front screen of the database, you can see the to-do list. This shows you any activity requiring follow-up on or before a date you choose. This is normally anything due today or earlier, i.e. due or overdue now, but you can change the date to see follow-ups in the future. For example, everything you need to do in the next week. In this case, we want to see all the follow-ups we have due by the end of next week, so let's change this to Friday next week. Clicking the List button allows us to see our current to-do list. Here we can see the meeting we entered earlier because the follow-up is due in the next week, so on or before the date we asked to see the list for. You can print this list using the Print List button. This shows the to-do list in print preview, ready to be printed off or saved as a PDF if you want to email it to someone. To save as a PDF, click the PDF or XPS button, enter a file name, and then click Publish. This will open the PDF. To email, click the Email button, and then click PDF from the list, then press OK. The PDF will be attached, and you will be able to send the email. Returning back to the on-screen list, we can use the arrow button to jump to see the full details of a contact if we need to. For example, if we want to remind ourselves who Jeffrey is before calling him to follow up. Once we've followed up on the meeting we had with Jeffrey, we can click Done to fill today's date in the Date Completed box automatically. This takes that reminder off the to-do list and keeps a record of when we completed the follow-up within the contact history area of the address book. And those are the main functions of the system. Now let's look at some areas you can customize to suit you within the standard Simple CRM system. From the Admin tab of the front screen, you can customize the contact types that appear in the drop-down list in contact history. Double-click on contact types in the list or single-click and click View to open the list. As you can see, the records shown in the list are the entries that appear in the contact types drop-down box under contact history. We can add a new one if there's a different type of activity you need to keep track of. So for an example, we will add conference here. If we now return to the contact screen, we will be able to see the new entry in the list. You can also set up the database properties from the Admin tab. This screen includes the project name on the front screen, the file path and file name of the logo file for the front screen, and the folder path for the contacts folders, where all the different linked folders for contacts are stored. You can edit these here if you need to adjust any of the file locations. You will also see a backup path and back file name. These link to the final function of the database, backups. On the Admin tab of the front screen, you will see a Compact and Backup Backend button. Clicking into here allows us to view two options, Compact and Backup Back or Backup Back. These buttons allow you to automatically create a copy of the back file of the database. The back file is the one containing your data. Creating backups is something you should do routinely to ensure you don't lose data accidentally in the future. The Compact and Backup Back button will also compact the database file, essentially shrinking it down and getting rid of redundant used space. This is helpful to maintain the reliability of the database. Click the Compact and Backup Back button and follow the steps to create a backup in the backups path we saw earlier. That's how the Simple CRM system can work for you. If you choose to purchase a Simple CRM database from us, you can use the system as is, as we've shown you here, or you can customize it further to suit your needs. You can either do this yourself or contact us to add to the system for you. The price for the system, correct for 2022, is £299 plus VAT. If you're interested, please click the link on the screen now or in the description to fill in an inquiry form and we'll call you back, or call 01747 822 616 to speak to someone right away. Note that this price includes 1 hour of initial installation and support time. Thanks for watching.